Big Boy, aka Daddy Fat Sacks, aka Solutions L Left Foot. The L stand for lavender, cause the ladies like to put lip gloss on my lapel, but I'm married as hell, and we're live in Stankonia with the birds. Up there we got Tula, right here we got Simon, and right here is Houdini. Tula is the chiller, she's a Brazilian now. Like, she's really cool, laid back, she's the oldest. Simon is very quiet, but you wouldn't even know she was there. Like, I mean, sometimes you forget she was in the room. This one over here, Houdini, I like to say he on that stuff, like on that shit. He's very, very rambunctious, but Hootie, which is my personal favorite, always falling asleep, one eye open, one eye closed, I always fuck with her, tell her to wake up. I'm the only person I know that'll tell an owl to wake up in the nighttime. I didn't realize how ludicrous that was until I was like, it's nighttime, it's an owl. I mean, I had birds, cockatoos and finches that lasted for about 3 days and they died quick. But my assistant, Shay, is into parrots and she got like a couple of macaws and she met this trainer named Rory who's like an exotic pet guy and she was like, I'm gonna bring him to the studio. He's like, he got everything. I was like, he don't have no owls. I'm like, yes, he do. So he came to the studio one night and had the little bird with him. And I was like, oh man, I want one. He's like, I can get you an owl. So that's when Simon came into the picture. And so then I was like, I want to get some baby birds. Like the owls, like when they're furry and they got the down feathers on them, they're like puppies. So that's when I got Hootie and then Shay got Houdini. And so it's Hootie Hoo. And that's the bird family. It's just come from being an animal lover. Like me and my brother have been into dogs for so long. We've been breeding bullies and Frenchies now for like 20 years. And I just always love animals, like from having sharks in my aquarium to different things like that. Persian cats and the whole nine yards. From the Miss Jackson video, I noticed that the bird in Miss Jackson video, I didn't know until after I got these birds, was actually, these are eagle owls. It's the same type of bird. See how God worked? Ooh, I am for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry. I ain't gonna start that shit. Gotcha. So it starts with the trainer coming and showing you how to hold them and actually getting a glove and them being comfortable with you. Like, cause I used to have them just around the house, kind of just like walking around and then they had like maybe one perch or whatever when they were smaller. But like now, say if I'm out of town, whatever, Roy has a bird habitat, so he keeps the birds for me. And I'm actually building a bird habitat for all of them. But I like them indoors because as you can see, once they perch, then they're there. You know what I mean? Unless you're gonna feed them or something, or they see something stray run across the floor, they're gonna pretty much relax. Like, I can sit here and smoke 10 blunts and they won't move at all. But I don't smoke around, don't tell Pete, I don't smoke around the birds. Give him. They eat mice about this size right here. They started with little baby mice, a whole mouse, so just eat it. But now they're graduated to like the medium-sized mice that you order online. And I bought a new deep freezer full of dead mice. You know, my wife is creeped out by that shit. Or either you can feed them like chicken breasts. They like the flat part of the chicken wing, like the part nobody eat, the gristle. They'll fuck that up too. But as far as activities, I mean, just letting them fly from glove to perch, and they just kind of just walk around. They just sit here and just look at you like our kid. These are my protectors. People like owls symbolize death. I don't know about that, must be a wives' tale. Bad luck, or they're gonna scratch your eyes out. I was nervous about the eye part at first, because they stare you like they're staring into your soul. So I'm like, I'm gonna keep my shades on right now, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? But now I just, boy. Yeah, I'm talking about, we got comfortable with him. It's mesmerizing, man. He just, you know what I'm saying? Like. It's what we call it, reckless eyeballing. Yeah, you better look away. I don't really let them around puppies and stuff like that because they will chase a dog. They would think it's food or whatever. Like, they kind of fluff up like a turkey and get the rocking side to side, and that's when you know they kind of like, okay, I'm gonna go after this dog. So we keep the puppies away from them. You know, they represent wisdom to me, you know what I mean? You just gotta have the space, the time, and the knowledge of the bird. I don't just encourage everybody to do that. I personally want a tiger. I've wanted a tiger for so long, but I just know by the time the tiger get pit bull size, it'll motherfucking kill me. So that's what stopped me from getting a tiger. Peter. Yeah. Good job. Good job. Say, hey, start that weak shit. No, you bet not. You bet not. You bet not. I get that butt. give me that butt. I get that butt.